and welcome to Woodbridge, the best town around. My name is John McCormick. I'm the mayor of this great town, and we're here today for an official groundbreaking ceremony for a very exciting project, the Grande at Metro Park. We are on the site of the former Ronson Building off Route 1, right behind Bed Bath & Beyond on Route 1 South. This is going to be turned into 355 luxury apartments, a commuter transit village. We're hoping that most of the people, if not all the people here, become commuters to Metro Park. It's a very short drive right down the street. There's also plans for shuttles to get people to and from the office park here, down to the train and here. It's going to be four buildings, each with their own design. They're all going to include patio space, walking paths, a dog park, fitness center, clubhouse, and entertainment center, and also 12,000 square feet of retail. This is a very, very exciting project in town. This site is actually brings back a lot of memories. I grew up right across the parkway in Menlo Park Terrace, where my mom still meets. Still lives. There used to be a Fox Theater, a theater here right on Route 1, just over there. And we'd frequently go under the parkway through a tunnel, which our parents never liked. And we were always told, stay away from Ronson, because the place is heavily contaminated. Don't go near the Ronson Building. You can go to the theater, and you can go to, there was something else up there, I'm trying to think what it is now. But we were not allowed to come on the site. I mean, this place made butane. I mean, this was a massive cleanup to get this building done. So that is an added benefit of the entire project, because we cleaned up a very, very contaminated site in town. To my left are the two people responsible for economic development in town. I get to do the groundbreaking, I get to do the ribbon cutting, and all the work in between is done by Marta Levski, our planning director, and Carolyn Ehrlich, our chief of staff, and the head of our redevelopment agency. This is a redevelopment project. It's got a payment in lieu of tax incentive here. There's a whole lot going on, and I want to publicly recognize Carol and Marta. I call them my right arm and my left arm for the job they've done in getting this project to fruition. And now, without further ado, to introduce the rest of the people here and his team from the Grande Metro Park Development Group, I'd like to call up Charles Avery.
Thank you, Mayor. Well, we're going to be here for about 45 minutes while I talk. Is that okay? But I'm going to adhere to the five B's of be brief, brother, be brief. So I just want to thank everybody for coming out today. I just want to let you know that we had acquired this property about a year ago, and we've been working closely with the mayor and with Marta and Caroline to make this a great part of the Woodbridge community. So I wanted to, I hats off to everybody at Woodbridge, has been so cooperative, and certainly John Haggerty and Tom Kelly, the construction official, and we thank all of them for helping us out and moving this project along to the point where you can see today where it's really moving along. So just to describe the what we're doing here, the Grande Metro Park, it's an exciting apartment home community, and it's located, the reason we like this is because it is truly in the hub of New Jersey. It is what you really call Central Jersey, where the Turnpike, the Parkway, Route 1, 287, everything is close by. And the, as the mayor had mentioned, this Ronson contaminated site, through the foresight and progressiveness of the local government, we've reinvigorating and revitalizing this part of the town. We bought it when it was, all the cleanup was already done, but the relationship between the developer and the town, and that partnership has created a positive impact that now can be actually implemented. So we have floor plans ranging from three bedroom lofts of 1,500 square feet with two baths, and we have layouts and finishes and amenities that are designed to impress the most discriminating people. We spent the last year working with our incredible architects at DMR, and we thank you for that, and we've created some amazing interiors. We have indoor amenity space, we have a large fitness center, we have large oversized gathering rooms, we have a outdoor theater, we have a coffee bar, we have pet washing stations, we have a dog park, all of these to create great housing alternatives and feel like an upscale hotel. That it's exciting, and we're also excited to introduce it to the community. We hope to be able to service the needs of the community, the surrounding office and commercial properties that are around here. We've put in a 12,000 square foot retail complex within this first building here, and also in the last phase we'll have another a few thousand square feet. So this this will really improve the access or the availability that the people have in the area. So lastly, I just wanted to introduce or acknowledge certainly that TD Bank is here and all the help that they've given us to finance the construction of the community. They had helped us to build a 145-unit apartment complex in Bound Brook, and then they've decided to come alongside of us here, and we're really excited about that. And they obviously have a critical role in the development process. In addition to the part of the 355 units, is 36 affordable units that will be constructed as part of the complex. We expect to have a revenue to Woodbridge Township of about $1 million a year through their taxes. So we think that this is a wonderful achievement that's been made by the mayor and the entire team. And I just want to acknowledge everybody else that's here. And we have our landscape architect here, and DMR, the architects, and Meridian Capital. And so we're really appreciative to everybody that's helped us bring it this far. And as you can see behind me, there's been a great deal of success. We have anywhere between 70 and 100 people on site every day. So I thank you for coming out. We're going to have a shoveling, so to speak, here in a second. But I didn't know if Carolyn or Marta wanted to speak at all. Or
Okay. I told the mayor I didn't want to speak, but I can't say no to you.
My girl.
So the first time I came out to the site was a few weeks ago, and I was totally impressed with how many people and machines and the work that was going on. Charles does not take a break. This is going to happen faster, I think, than even you imagine. And you and your teams are just terrific. We are so excited to have this here in town, and look forward to continuing to work with you. Thank you.
I'll just echo what Carol and the mayor said. We're thrilled that the redevelopment has begun. It's going to be a terrific project, and we can't wait to see it, and happy to work with you on it.
Thank you.
All right, so I'm pretty much the easiest guy in America to buy a gift for. You either have to make it New York Yankees, Bruce Springsteen, or Miller Lite. All my wardrobe, my casual wardrobe, has one of those three on the T-shirt. So I'm very happy that I was given an official New York Yankees hard hat with my name on it. I am not going to attempt to try it on because I have a very, very large head, and no hard hat has ever fit me. When I played Pop Warner football, they had to go out and get a special helmet made to fit on my head, and I'm not exaggerating. There's also somebody was given a Met helmet. He's not here right now because he just jumped in the ditch after the four-game sweep of the Yankees over the Mets, the first two in Yankee Stadium, the next two in Citi Field. I was at the middle game.
Be careful, he might lose his funding.
So I want to thank the Mets for the last four games, and we're on to sweep Boston, and you're not doing anything. So now I believe we're going to go have a little shovel ceremony. Let's go. Let's go break ground.